Today we invited Menno Rubens, architect and project developer at CPZ Projects. We will talk about the circular business model behind the temporary courthouse in Amsterdam. Hi Menno, welcome.
Hi, Mom.
You were responsible for the development of the temporary courthouse in Amsterdam. How temporary is it? And how did the temporary character affect the business model?
The building is a temporary courthouse, as the name says, but the building itself is a permanent building. It's only now temporary in use as a courthouse, but it can be disassembled and used on other places as a different in a different function. It can also be adjusted on site for a different function. So the building is temporarily used as a courthouse, but it's a permanent building.
I understand this building is designed as a circular product. What does that actually mean, a building as a product?
A building as a product is very similar to how different other products are made, like vacuum cleaners or cars or aeroplanes. You add value to a product by making it as a kit of parts, all different elements that make the entire building. And you, as a building, you can also have different life cycles in the building. Now the building is a courthouse. In a second life, it will be a different function. It can be a school or an office. And it can have, in every life cycle, it will generate revenues. So you don't have to earn the building back and make your profits in the first use only, but you can have different uses for it. By making a building as a product, you also make it dismountable, make it entirely disassemble. So you can take it apart and reassemble it on a different site. And for that use, we developed certain building elements that can be very easily disassembled, like the hollow core concrete slabs that normally are fixed to the steel structure, but now are dismountable from the steel structure. So both the steel structure and the concrete elements can be disassembled and reused on a different site.
That's very interesting. So compared to the linear business model of take, make and waste, which values are created through the application of circular business models?
Contradiction to the linear model, which you described as take, make, waste, the circular model is based on the intrinsic value of the product. So you add value to the product, which makes it easier to have a different life cycle and to make revenues over different life cycles. So the multiple use of the building is the basis of the business case. The first use is the courthouse, the second use will be on a different place and with a different function and with its different revenues. And that's very different from the classical statical real estate approach, where you make a building, put it on the site, and when the site is no longer attractive, then the building is no longer attractive. But with our model, with our dynamic building as a product model, we can still take the building, put it on the other side, and generate again revenues for the users on that side. So that's a very different approach from the static real estate to the dynamic real estate approach.
I thought that a courthouse is quite a specific building.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. How do you deal with that? Is it easy to transform it into an office building, or
yeah,
how do you deal with the specificness of some buildings like courthouses?
Yeah, the courthouse has like security cameras and all kinds of different security measures. Those are all added on to the main structure. So the main structure is very generic. We had some higher floor levels to accommodate future different functions like laboratories or schools or even housing. And all the stuff, and all the small parts that are specifically for the courthouse, like the cameras, like the furniture, like the that can be taken out in the next use and has a and will not be used in the future, because the chances that this building will be a courthouse again in its second life are very very small.
So the layers that are part of the building are clearly separated from each other, as we learned in the previous videos from Stuart Brand.
From Stuart Brand, the shearing layers of Brand, there are we applied them to this building. So the main structure, the facade, is also very adaptable to new sites, and the inner walls, inner separation walls, some of them can be reused on a new site. Some of them are so specific for the courthouse, like bulletproof glass elements, which will not be reused in a new site.
Can you explain how the circular economy approach affected the way the design and development process was organized? So, and which advantages did it bring for all the stakeholders that were involved, both designers and contractors and manufacturers?
Yeah, we had to work very closely together with a team of both contractors, subcontractors, engineers, architects in a very early stage. Together with all those stakeholders, we defined the key performance indicators that would lead to successful projects. And throughout the whole process, every design decision has to be checked according to those key performance indicators. So that gave us a tool to, during the entire process, monitor what we were doing, if we still are on the path of success for the entire building, and also everybody knew from each other what they were expected to do. And so we had, in a very early stage, knowledge about the building techniques, the building the costs, the time that it would take to assemble and disassemble certain parts of the building. And that are things that you cannot do only as an architect, you cannot only do as a project developer, you cannot only do as a subcontractor or contractor, you really have to work together in one system, one dynamic building information model to really have the control over the process.
So it strongly affected the organization of the design process. Could you explain how you did that? Because you're from CPZ Projects, it's the project development part of an architect's company. So what does it mean for the role of the design designers in such a process?
Yeah, as CPZ, as the architecture firm CPZ, we are very much used to already get involved in the early stages of the design process and also in the building stages of the process, of the entire building process. So that's also why we established two firms to manage the project development and also the building process. So for us, it's a very natural way of looking at the process. We talk a lot about it with other architects, which are very much willing to have more influence on the process. And so then you have to also have to take responsibility for your design choices, so you really have to know what you're doing. So you really have to form the group of experts to fit in the voids that you don't know. So it's really very much about knowing what you don't know and getting the right people in your team and trusting them and really taking a responsibility for your decisions.
5 years for a building is not a long time. That's the time that the building should be used. So how did this influence the strategy for the end of service stage? What happens with the building and its materials afterwards?
The whole business model is based on keeping the building and the building materials together as a kit of parts and disassembling, reassembling on a new site. So we're not very much interested in putting the different building elements in another building on another site. So the most value is contained in the building as a product if you keep all the products together. That doesn't mean that it's one of the best recyclable buildings in the Netherlands, because every material can be disassembled from the other material. So there's no welding in the building, there's no gluing in the building. So all the elements, there's no poured concrete in the building. So all the elements can be really easily disassembled in first to make the building on a different site. But if that's not possible, then it can be distributed in different building elements. But that would be for us a bit of a downgrade of the whole business model.
Yeah.
But in the end, it's also so the worst case is still a very attractive case.
And which role does standardization play in the design?
In the building industry in the Netherlands has some standards in measurements, like 60 centimeters, multiples of that. But we don't want to make a building system that can be can be every kind of building all over the world and be connected to all the other buildings. There are a lot of people who have tried to invent a system like that over the past few hundred years, and none of them succeeded. So we are focusing on making the building as a product as valuable as possible, as intelligent as possible, as efficient as possible. And if you strive for efficiency, for effectiveness, then you get the durability, you get the sustainability, you get the circular aspects also with it.
And how does it affect how the building looks like? Will the same assignments in within 5 years lead to the same design? So how is the relation with the design of the building?
No. Well, I don't think it's limited to a certain kind of design. We at CPZ have, we want to design buildings in a certain way. So if you look at a building, you always recognize it as a typical CPZ building. But that's our signature. That doesn't mean that all circular buildings have to be like a CPZ design. You can use different materials, you can use different forms, that's not a problem. So it's more about the principle of how you put buildings together. If you put buildings together, always think about how you're going to take them apart. Maybe not in 5 years, maybe not in 10 years, maybe in 40 or 50 years. And when somebody is taking your building apart, if it's easy to take apart, they will thank you for it later.
That was already the last question. Thank you, Menno, for this very interesting interview.
Thank you.
Hope to see you back.
Yeah.
Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video with Menno Rubens. See you back next time. Bye.
Bye.